Hey there, and welcome back to the episode of the B2B Marketing Asia podcast. I'm your host, Joe Escobedo. Joining me today is Virginia Batista, who is a LinkedIn and personal branding strategist. Virginia, so glad to have you on the show.
Hey, Joe. It's so nice to be here and so great to see you again. Thank you for inviting me here.
Absolutely. Really excited because today you're going to be talking about how you are able to attract clients from 10 countries in over 5 regions with only personal branding and inbound, no advertising. Is that correct?
No advertising, no outbound lead generation, only inbound marketing and personal branding. You're correct.
There we go. So I know you have 5 tips to share, but I think before we go into those 5 tips, I think a lot of people will be wondering, how did you get started? For those of you who, you know, are just getting new to LinkedIn or social media, how did you start?
In my case, as you probably have known this, but for the audience who are not familiar, so I was from the corporate. After 11 years from the corporate, I jumped into full-time freelancing, and I was freelancing for 7 years. And then if you remember the Forbes feature, that was a game changer for me. I had my first client in 2017. I don't have a business yet, so I didn't know what to do, but I did what I have to do, and that started everything. That started BB Consulting. So now we help coaches, consultants, and entrepreneurs build their influence on LinkedIn and monetize their expertise through personal branding and, you know, content marketing.
Absolutely. And so when you were just getting started, do you have a clear strategy, or how did you go about your first LinkedIn post? I know it was a while back,
When I started, I actually had no idea what I was doing on LinkedIn. But then when you are consistently doing it, you will observe what's working and what's not working. So that's when I started also studying it and testing until I discovered really what works and what doesn't work. And because LinkedIn rolls out a lot of updates without announcing, hey, we have new updates. So you really have to be doing it yourself. You really have to be right there doing it and applying it using your own profile and testing and experiment. It's really just like that. I learned it because it worked, and then I studied what's working and what's not.
Yeah, absolutely. And you've definitely learned a lot over the years. And so I'd love to get your thoughts on what are those 5 tips, the things that really worked out for you and able to attract all your customers.
5 tips. Okay. Number 1, Joe, keywords. As you know, on LinkedIn, it's a huge search engine. So when I have these clients from countries that, you know, I haven't had clients before, the first thing I ask them when they come to me, how did you find me? And many of them, especially in 2020, last year, mentioned that they found me through Google search. So I always ask them, so do you remember the keywords that you used? Then they would tell me the keywords. Actually, because of those, I went to Google search using incognito mode, and I typed in the keywords that they told me they found me for. And I see that I'm on page 1 of Google search. So I think it's working. So keywords are very important. Optimize your profile, put the right keywords that you want to be found for, and you will rank high on LinkedIn searches. Not only on LinkedIn searches, but also you will capture page 1 of Google search. The keywords, that will be number 1. Number 2, Joe, will be stories. If you go to LinkedIn, all the posts, the majority of the posts there, they're talking about their product, they're talking about their services, but they're actually not telling their stories. They're not sharing their journey. But what I see working on LinkedIn is that you really have to tell your story, because we're humans and stories connect the way no stats, no figures, no numbers would connect. And until now, my most valuable post, most valuable meaning the posts that have led to a lot of leads, and I easily have converted them to clients. That's still my personal story, my backstory. The story when I shared how I applied at LinkedIn Singapore, and then I was rejected, so I didn't even get an interview. But because I love LinkedIn, I continued doing what I love doing until I became an independent LinkedIn consultant. So stories matter a lot. And most people don't use stories, and that's why. And they keep wondering what's not working. And it's because the stories make a lot of sense, even in B2B marketing. Number 3, engagement. Engage with other people's content. And I think it's very important to just be genuinely interested in others. People say, people might tell you, okay, keep on posting on LinkedIn, be consistent in posting, even if you post every day or three times a day. But if you're not engaging with other people's content, that's not going to work. Even if you just post and then you will see you will not have visibility. But try engagement. Try showing interest in other people. Try engaging with their content. Try supporting them when they say that they have a new job. Just congratulate them and you will see that things will change in your LinkedIn profile. And people will also be interested in you and they will click on your profile. And once your profile is optimized and you clearly define what you do, they will contact you if they need your services. Number four, Joe, is community. I always say I build my personal brand by building other people's personal brand. And I'm not just talking about my clients. I'm talking about building a community. This is an organic community that I have built along the way. I'm not sure if you're familiar, but I have this top 100 Filipinos to follow on LinkedIn for inspiration and learning. It's totally community driven. And this is very powerful. Many of my valued clients came to me through engagement, through the posts of those who are in the 100 list of Filipinos to follow on LinkedIn, because these people also have huge network on LinkedIn. So let me recap before I go to number five: keywords, stories, engagement, and community. Now, all of these four, Joe, will help you attract leads, will help you get people to contact. Now, what are you going to do with them? Build relationships. You have to build a relationship not only with your professional network on LinkedIn, but also build a relationship with your clients. And whether they turn into a client or not, they would still be on LinkedIn, they would still see your post. So even if you're not able to convert them, you still have to build a relationship with them, because you never know, once they're ready to buy, they will contact. So those are the five factors. I call it the five pillars, Joe, that actually helped me reach more than 10 countries. We have served more than 10 countries or clients from more than 10 countries in 5D worldwide without spending any ads at all. It's all inbound.
Yeah, no, that's super impressive. Like I said, I think a lot of people are wondering, is it a tool or is it some kind of outreach program? But the fact that you have done it all inbound and through personal branding is extremely powerful. I'd love to break down the five pillars which you talked about: SEO, stories, engagement, community, and relationships. So let's start with SEO first. Mm-hmm. What are some SEO tips? So for example, you mentioned keywords, but how can they actually incorporate those keywords? Is it in the headline, in the summary, in their job experience? And the second question I have for you is, what kind of keywords should they be putting in? Should they be putting in marketing managers? Should they be putting in marketing automation, more keyword-specific ones? What are some tips on both those questions?
Okay. In terms of keywords, they have to know the keywords that their target audience is actually using when they're searching for experts like them. I'm not going to use LinkedIn Ninja or LinkedIn Guru, because I'm sure that my target audience will not go to Google search and type in LinkedIn Ninja and looking for LinkedIn Guru or something. What is the keyword that your target audience is using? So you really have to know who your target audience is. It has to be very clear to you. Then use that on your profile. There's so many places on your LinkedIn profile that you should optimize for keywords. But number one will be your headline. Number one will be your headline. Number two, your about section. Number three, the position, the title, the description there. And also, if you want to get found on Google search, it's important also that you write articles. Now, a lot of people on LinkedIn, Joe, they stop writing articles because it has very low reach. And I can feel that, because it takes a lot of time to write long articles and then you get very few reach. But then you have to, there's a strategy there. How can you get more reach? But let's talk about the SEO side of it. When you publish an article, the keywords there, it is also being crawled by Google. And recently I've seen that people are saying, but I haven't confirmed this, that now even LinkedIn posts are being crawled on Google. So it's very important that you really write content. Some people will just use images and all that. They don't write articles. They don't like text. They don't like text. They don't write text. But all of these help you in getting found through the right key.
Awesome. And I guess the question is, what keywords? So for example, I'm in B2B marketing, I'm a consultant. Should I use the keyword like B2B marketing consultant? Is that something, a keyword you recommend for me?
If that's something that your target audience is using, then yes, use that keyword. We can't be too creative. If that creativity using keywords that our target audience is not using won't help us, then there's no point becoming too creative. So for example, in your case, because you're targeting B2B companies, you need to have that keyword B2B on your LinkedIn profile, on your keywords throughout your profile as well.
Awesome. I think I do have that. So
you have it.
All right. The second one that you talked about is stories. And I think a lot of people struggle with what kind of story should they be telling and how do they get started in crafting that story. So what are some advice for those folks?
Number one, your backstory is super valuable. People want to know, whatever you're doing, what makes you do that? What is your why? This is cliche, Joe, but this is cliche because it works. People want to know your story. People want to know how before you become successful, what are the struggles you had in the past? Because these are all relatable. But then again, you have to be strategically authentic in posting. You just post anything. Just if you tell a story, any story will do. Definitely not. You have to be strategic with that as well. So tell your story, but make sure that story is anchored on your overall brand. So if, for example, you're a B2B marketing consultant, what is the story behind being a B2B marketing consultant? So always align the story with your overall branding. And don't just tell any story that is not relevant to your expertise, to who you are. So always anchor that on what you do so that people also will recognize what you do. But in general, as long as it's authentic, as long as it's you, no one's going to tell you don't tell that story because you will be surprised. Those stories that you didn't want to tell, those are the stories that catch on.
I love that last line. The stories you don't want to tell are the ones that catch on LinkedIn. So I think that's great advice. And moving on to tip number three, which is engagement. And you talked about engaging in other people's posts. Now, I know a lot of folks, particularly salespeople, they tend to just say, hey, great post. Good job. Nice. Insightful. Is that the type of engagement you'd recommend for people? Or how do you take that a little bit deeper?
It's a big no, Joe, but I understand there's still a lot of people who are doing that. And you know what? The reason is this, because they go to LinkedIn with the wrong mindset. If you go to LinkedIn because you're thinking about how many can I sell today? Who can I sell to today? That's the wrong mindset. The right mindset is you have to be interested in other people. You have to be able to help them. And when you do engagement, you have to make sure that it makes sense. Every comment you make should contribute to solidifying and making your personal brand strong. So it cannot just be nice posts, great posts. And I see people joining LinkedIn pods. And it's very obvious that they on the pod because sometimes the comments are not even related to the post. And you don't want this because you want to convert genuine conversation into meaningful relationships, and those relationships are the ones that will give you business. It's not the reach, it's not the like, it's not that. It's the genuine relationship that comes from genuine interest in other people. And you really have to invest time in that. No one can do that for you.
Yeah, so I guess that means actually looking at what the person has wrote or the video they've been featured in and providing some kind of commentary based on that. Was that something that would be more helpful than just a, hey, great post, great job type of message?
Absolutely, Joe, absolutely.
Awesome. And for those of you who are not familiar with pods, maybe you can explain what pods are to folks.
Oh, there are pods out there. I think even in other social media platforms. And there's a group in which if you join that pod, it's like they have an understanding that they will be engaging with each other's posts. Because I've also encountered potential clients who reach out to me and they will tell me that they've been using pods for quite some time. Yes, they're getting likes and engagement, but they're not able to convert that into business. And the reason for that is that it's hard to build a relationship when you just scratch my back and I'll scratch yours, something like that. So it doesn't work because you have to be really interested in others if you want to get results from that.
Absolutely. Moving on to tip number four, community. how do you actually go about building a community? I know a lot of folks want to do it, but what are some of your tips?
Others will actually build community on Facebook, and it's really working well. But in my case, it just started in 2018. I saw this post from Marketing in Asia. It's 47 icons, LinkedIn icons from Malaysia. When I saw that, I became interested, and I mentioned to Azlin, the one who authored that, I also wanted to create something like this for the Philippines. And it's because it's part of my advocacy, really, to help work Filipinas go to LinkedIn, get on board LinkedIn, and attract more opportunities for themselves. So I created that. The goal is, number one, there are so many newbie Filipinas on LinkedIn. When they go to LinkedIn, they don't know what to do. And so I thought, if they will see a list of Filipinas that they want to follow by industry or depending on what their criteria could be, then at least they have a starting point. Because they don't know, where do I get connections? So at least when they see a list, they know where to start. And number two, I also want to recognize Filipinas who are also very active on LinkedIn and helping others through their stories and through their experience. So it just started with that one idea, one article. And then I saw the positive impact. So from the first year, I did it again the second, third, and this year we're on the fourth year of recognizing all the top 100 Filipinas on LinkedIn. And it's all organic, Joe. It's community driven. It's not for me to decide who will be on the top 100. We set a criteria and I asked my network to tag the Filipinos they follow on LinkedIn. And then from the shortlist, from the nominees, we shortlist them. So it's community driven. They are the ones who nominated them. And I see this is very powerful because it came from the community. When you recognize the top 100, you also recognize the community because these are, you know, nominated by the people in the community. And I see a lot of power in this.
Yeah, I absolutely love that for so many different reasons. The organic community, the people voting for who they would like, because a lot of times the organizations or even individuals create these lists or these awards, but they're really not doing anything but pandering them. So they're basically making them feel good so they can try to sell them something. Or they're trying to charge a price so they can be on this prestigious list. But the fact that you said, okay, I'm not responsible in terms of who goes on the list. I'm going to set the criteria. I'm going to open it up to anyone who wants to vote. Let me know who you think is on that list. And then based on that, we'll go ahead and add those people accordingly. So I love that idea.
And the good thing about this, Joe, I just want to add very quickly. The good thing about that, it makes other Filipinos aspire for it. And because they aspire to be in the top 100, they become active on LinkedIn. And I think when they become active, they know the drill. You have to help. It's not just going there talking about yourself, but it's really going to LinkedIn and then helping others as well. Not just thinking about your self-interest. It gives them a reason to really become more active on LinkedIn.
Absolutely. And rounding up the list at number 5, sorry, watching too much YouTube videos, that's relationships. So for relationships, what do we mean by relationships? What kind of relationships are we trying to build and how do we go about building those relationships?
So as I mentioned, everyone that you will get through keywords, stories, engagement, and community, don't just engage with them one time. Even if you're not able to convert them, it's okay. Build relationships, meaning stay in touch with them. And there are many ways to do that on LinkedIn. For example, you know, we've known each other in 2017. And I'm happy now. I'm glad that we're still connected. We still talk. And when we talk on LinkedIn through direct messages, it seems like we just saw each other yesterday. So it's like that. When you know that this person needs help, you help them. And you will be surprised when you help them either through direct messaging, through your post. You will be surprised that when you need something, you don't even have to ask. They will help you without you asking for it. And that's really powerful. I think that's the key, the major key, build relationships with people.
And absolutely.
It will help accelerate your growth. Sorry, Joe.
You know, absolutely. I think you were spot on. And I think those were some wonderful tips. Virginia, thank you so much. I really appreciate you coming on the show and sharing all of your insights. It's been super helpful for me and for everyone. And guys, if you're listening, do follow Virginia on LinkedIn. She's super knowledgeable on everything LinkedIn, personal branding. And if you enjoyed today's podcast, which I'm sure you did, please feel free to share today's episode. Thank you guys so much, and we'll see you soon. Take care, everyone. Bye.